So guys, finally I reached Stazione di Asmara, basically railway station of Asmara and whole of the Eritrea. And behind my back you can see the remaining carriages made in Italian time, when Italia was basically over this place, you know. And now we going to the train garage, basically, where there's I can see right now three big old ancient, you name it, trains resting. So guys, here we are, we reached the old ancient trains. The railway was built during Italian Eritrea in order to connect Massawa and Asmara, the main cities of Eritrea. The railway was fully opened in 1932. Construction began from the Red Sea port city of Massawa in 1887, heading towards the capital city of Asmara. So guys, here I am at Stazione di Asmara, railway station of Asmara basically, and here we are inside of the garage where we can see six heads of the trains, and let's just check one of them. Guys, inside of the cabin of the charcoal coal basically operating machine, you know. Wow guys, here's the piece of charcoal. As per the guide who's showing us around, he said that the charcoal they're importing from South Africa, such a long way through the whole Africa basically to bring I don't know how many tons of charcoals to run this machine, guys. Unbelievable. And here on this train behind my back over here, you can see there is a green sign, it says Ernesto Breda, Milano, 1937. So basically this horse was made in 1937 and brought from Milano, guys. Can you imagine? Straight from Milano, from Italy. Wow, this is unbelievable, the way it covered up to reach this African continent, guys. This is unbelievable. Guys, you know what is really interesting? That the station, actually the railway, is not operating, but people still doing some work, keeping some machines in a moving condition, you know. So still trying to maintain and keep them moving. Guys, look at the railway joint. It just had a pin that holds two parts together. Unbelievable. So guys, behind my back you see the mechanism. It's basically a train coming on the middle of this circle, like a railway. And then the circle starts rotating in any side. So just to turn around the train, you know, to change the directions. It's really a smart thing to use in the railway industry, and it's also made in 1911, guys. So guys, here is one of the carriages that's supposed to be for the passengers, and it looks so good. I mean, it's not that damaged, it's well preserved. Look at this kind of wow, this is amazing, guys. The carriage is so outstanding. So this is basically guys windows without glass, but it has like a shade, you know. It's supposed to be opening and closing like this, this way. It's like back in the day, back in the time. Guys, basically to be here, it's honestly worth it. But to see, yeah, to see the trains, carriages, all this history, it's worth to come. But be prepared to have $10 one knot, because they're not accepting here NACFA. They don't give change in NACFA, nothing. Only $10 per person, guys. Supposed to be, in my opinion, supposed to be everything free. But anyway, I paid $10 and I see everything. Everything looks gorgeous, historical. And guys, whenever you're in Asmara, come and visit railway station of Asmara. Here is a manual track switch and it's still working. It makes a lot of sounds, however, trains can be guided from one track to another.
Yeah, that's good.